I'm Robert Jay. I'm the Inspector of Mines with the New South Wales Resources Regulator based in Orange. I have over 48 years mining experience, 24 years as an inspector and 24 years industry experience working in underground mines in Broken Hill. The New South Wales Resources Regulator is dedicated to preventing incidents and injuries involving rotating or moving parts of drilling machinery, especially development jumbos at New South Wales mine sites.
My name is Anthony Seddon and I'm the Superintendent Underground at Cowgold Operations. A lot of work goes into producing the final product, including development drilling, production drilling, ground reinforcement and support installation. We are committed to achieving production targets through safe working practices. For this to occur, we work with our workers to ensure drilling is carried out following approved procedures. We are aware of incidents that have occurred in our industry where workers have been injured by rotating or moving parts from drilling machines. We rely on everyone, especially our supervisors and drill operators, to maintain approved controls to prevent entanglement.
Effective immobilisation controls must be in place to protect workers within jumbo operating zones. Mine operators must take a series of steps to minimise the risk of jumbo drilling entanglement.
Step one, conduct an operational risk assessment. Identify appropriate people for a risk assessment team. This should include a variety of workers, such as operators, offsiders, supervisors, and others who are familiar with underground drilling using a jumbo. They should be able to identify all equipment used, who could be harmed and how. This helps decide effective risk control measures and how to monitor them. Step 2. Identify sources of entanglement. Using the equipment manufacturer's manual and the operational risk assessment, identify sources of entanglement such as rotating and moving parts. These include the trailing cable, booms, shank, coupling, drill steel, and bit. Step 3. Identify devices for the removal of energies and immobilization of rotating parts. The equipment manual and operational risk assessment provide information on how to immobilize rotating or moving parts. Devices include immobilizer switches and emergency stop buttons fitted to the jumbo. Step 4. Develop and implement drilling procedures to address entanglement. The equipment manual and operational risk assessment form the basis for our safe operating procedure to prevent entanglement. The procedure should cover all the risk controls specified by the equipment manufacturer and, as identified by the operational risk assessment, include steps for drill steel and bit changes. Be readily available, be understood by workers, in particular operators, and be implemented, effective, and reviewed in a timely manner. Step 5. Provide appropriate training, information, instruction, and supervision to the relevant persons. Jumbo operators and offsiders require further training and assessment on risks to health and safety, in particular the drilling procedure, rotating or moving parts, electrical and mechanical energies, and immobilization switches. Drill steels and bits must not be inserted or changed before moving or rotating parts are immobilized. Other relevant workers, including supervisors, maintenance or technical personnel and visitors, will require instruction to ensure they do not enter drilling exclusion zones until all rotating or moving parts are effectively immobilized. This is about managing machinery hazards that cannot be designed out or guarded. Step 6. Establish exclusion zones to distinguish safe areas from danger zones. Where a jumbo drill is operating, safe and danger areas must be clearly marked. The operational risk assessment details the extent of the exclusion zone, the location and operation of protective measures such as active optoelectronic devices, laser curtains, physical barriers, and signage. If it's necessary to supervise, inspect, or conduct tests while the drill steel and other parts are rotating or moving, you will require a safe work instruction or risk assessment. Step 7. Identify further entanglement risks. The operational risk assessment would have included an assessment of the work area where the jumbo is to be operated. The underground environment presents additional hazards that could cause entanglement. These include loose clothing, stuck or jammed drill steel, trailing cable and reel, restricted work area, insufficient lighting, slips, trips and falls, longer working hours, high job demands, noise, and heat. Step 8. perform a drill and immobilisation test before commencing drilling. The equipment manual, the operational risk assessment, and site equipment maintenance arrangements should identify machine parts, components, and other aspects for pre-use checks. Protective devices such as immobilisation switches, emergency stops, laser curtains, and cameras, where installed, must be tested before full-scale drilling. The safe work procedure must detail how the protective devices will be tested if they are to be relied upon to prevent entanglement. Step 9. Position self and remain in the safe area, including in view of the operator and or offsider. Staying in the safe area when drilling is underway is critical. An operator must stay at the control platform. An offsider must stay behind the control platform in the operator's view so as to not accidentally approach the jumbo booms and other moving or rotating parts. A physical and/or optoelectronic barrier between the offsider and the control platform provides a higher level of protection. Positive communication between the operator and the offsider and other workers on site is critical. Step 10. Maintain the entanglement risk control measures for the duration of the task. The operational risk assessment would have identified the risk control measures, including the preparation of an implementation plan. Protection measures for operators, offsiders, and other workers might include stopping work when a control measure is absent or is no longer effective, stopping work when rotating or moving parts need replacement or maintenance, equipment pre-use checks, supervisor inspections, supervisor task observations, senior management observations, other relevant worker observations. Step 11. Evaluate the effectiveness of the entanglement risk control measures. The risk control implementation plan should inform the development of performance standards, including an evaluation of the control measures' effectiveness. This ensures gaps or ineffective controls are identified and improvements introduced before an incident occurs.
The New South Wales Resources Regulator is providing clear direction to the New South Wales mining industry to help prevent entanglement incidents. The regulator will take a zero tolerance approach where mine operators have not taken appropriate steps to manage this risk.